Hi everyone, it's Mikey and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So it's time for another rainy day project or a sharing kit. So this is what I call my cowboy ranch, or Ian, what Ian wants to call yeehaw. So you can call it whatever you want. So this comprises of some barbed wire shape, some barn stars, an ice cow skull, and some other little bits and pieces for your composition. Your substrate looks like three pieces of planks joined together. So we're back to wood again. So I've already pre-started to pop out the bits on this and suddenly realized that I should have shown you the full sheet, as you will get it. So this one has got a couple of stars just in that middle bit. So I'll just pop those out with my fingernail. We go. So that's now wastage. So then just go around the outside. Like I said before with these kits, if you're not sure where the tabs are to put the pressure on for releasing, just hold it up to the window or hold it up to a light source and it will show you where all the tabs are. So there's the barbed wire. There's the other little plank. That's where one of the tabs are there, and on the ends, just there and just there. And then we've got the barn stars. So just delicately do those. Just pop out, like I said, just using the old nail. There we go. This one's a bit bigger, so usually the bigger they are, if you'll pardon the expression, the easier they are to pop out. All right, Mr. Moose Skull. There, just on the cheekbones. And just one on the jawbone. Yes, okay. We can discard that now. So this is all the little bits that you get. So there's two barn stars. There's five smaller stars for balancing composition. There's the barbed wire. Another little plank for adding in a little bit of compositional pieces, kind of just to balance it up. So before I go and start putting all this together, I'm just going to spend a couple of seconds just going around. If I can feel a ridge where the tabs are, I'm just going to give them a quick rub with a Hemery board just to kind of get rid of those ridges. So I'll go around the rest of the kit. Screechy. Like so. And just remove those tabs and I'll join with you again in a little while. I think that is just about it. Okay, so now it's time just to kind of work on the composition a little bit. So I'm kind of drawn to what I did earlier. It just seemed natural to put that kind of there as a kind of balanced composition, but I want the barbed wire underneath the skull and I want it coming off the page slightly. Yeah, I like that. And then this piece down here. So the barn stars, maybe one up there coming off again, this one on the plank. And then maybe two of those stars coming down here, and then maybe one up there, one up there, bring that down a little bit maybe. I'm okay with negative space there, and I think I'm going to put that other one there just to balance it out, just give it a bit of extra height. So yeah, I think I'm kind of happy with that layout. So what I need to do is I need to take a photograph of that so I know where everything's going to go, and I can reference it later, and then we can start on decorating. So just before I break all this apart again, like I said, I have taken a photograph of it so I can reference it back later on my phone. There's nothing stopping you from twisting this around and having your composition a totally different way if you wanted to. So you could put yours, say, this way, and have that up there, and then have your other bind stars, big one, and then maybe the little one. There's absolutely nothing stopping you from doing that. Obviously, it's up to you. So before I get back to doing what I was going to be doing, so I want to add some texture paste to the planks here. So I'm going to use that wood grain stencil again. I'm using the Tim Holtz one because I've never created a wood grain stencil for myself, because I've always had this one to play with. So this is getting a bit dry in here, but that should be enough. So I'm going to come down directly on. Normally I put the texture paste on my mat. I'm not particularly bothered about getting a perfect wood grain on this. It's literally just kind of a hint of. That's that bit. So I'll turn that round, and then I'm going to manoeuvre that over. Get some more. I'm not going to do the middle bit just yet because I want to get I want to get this dry before I attempt to put the other one on, mainly because I don't want to smudge it. I hope you can see what I'm doing down there. So I'll go and wash this off, clean up this bit here, get these two bits dried, clear out those two channels there because they've got texture paste that have gone into those holes, which I don't want. Like so, and then I'll be right back after making a mess. All right, so that's all dry. So I'm going to add the texture paste onto this piece now, but I also want to add it onto this piece as well. So, and of course, why not add a nice little bit of that knot pattern while we can. So let me just move that out of the way and bring that into the middle. Pick a little bit off that and then just gently scrape that through stuck to the back. There we go. And then I can just run my finger around the edge just to take off any excess. There we go. And I can put that to one side. And then bring this piece back. I'm going to turn it round just so we get a different kind of pattern. And then drop that on that side. I'm trying to work from the edges in this time. So that I'm not going back over the same place too much where I went last time. There we go, that should do us. Straight up. Yes, happy with that. Okay, so once again, I need to go get this cleaned up, get all this lot cleaned up, back in the pot, get it dried off, and then I'll be back as soon as I've done all that. All right, so they're all dry and done now. I think they're looking rather lovely. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little bit of that texture paste just onto the barbed wire, because I want it to have that kind of corroded, rusty look to it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a piece of sponge. I'm just going to pick up a little bit of that texture paste, and I'm just going to go over the top. And because the texture paste is fine, it'll give me a real kind of fine, gritty, almost corroded effect. And I'm not going to go everywhere. Well, I am going to go everywhere, but I'm going to go heavier in some places and lighter in others. You'll see where I've gone lighter, because they'll still be able to see a bit of the wood underneath. So where the barb bit of the barbed wire is, some places will go a bit heavier. And this will do, like I said, two things. It will it'll give it that texture, but also it will act as a bit of a primer as well, because there is titanium white in that texture paste. And again, I'm going to give just a little bit of texture onto the horns of the skull, because it is weathered. But not the actual skull itself. So just a little bit of texture. There we go. So we'll leave that to dry. And then just a little bit on those barn stars. Don't want everything to look too smooth. We want them to look old. Old and rusty and corroded and weathered. So they've been outside, stuck on a barn door for years and years and years. Okay, so I'm going to let that look dry. I'll have a quick tidy up, clean up, and I'll be back when everything is dry and ready for its first coat of paint. Let's just move that out of the way. Ready for cleaning. All right, so that's dry. Everything else is dry. My heat gun is now packed up. It's just died mid drying session. So what I'm going to do is, it is still hot, so I'm just going to leave it to cool down, see whether it comes back on again. If not, I'm going to have to buy another heat gun. I do have a spare one, that's fine, but for the time being, we don't really need it for the next few minutes or so. So what I'm going to do is I haven't fully kind of decided on the colour palette that I want to use for this particular project. So my first instinct is saying go wood and go rust. So browns and oranges, and then maybe something on the skull. But I don't know whether I want to do that. I don't know whether I want to do one consolidated colour and then just highlight over the top. I can't decide just yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in with some of the brown paint. So this is Hot Cocoa from Indigo Blue. So this is a dark brown paint. And what I'm going to do is probably just give it its first coat. And then if I want to go lighter for weathered wood, I can come back in with a lighter brown over the top, because weathered wood tends to go lighter. Almost silvery if it's left outside, or sometimes, depending on the type of wood. See, I'm trying to think of like variations that I could do. The last rainy day project I did was brown and rusty. So I don't particularly want to do the same thing again, because, you know, I ain't a one trick pony. Also, you know, I want it to be interesting for you guys to watch, to get, you know, to see something different. So, and to show that you can employ a variety of different paint palettes and colours, and, you know, it's okay to fall back on your favourites or step outside your comfort zone with a colour palette you wouldn't normally have tried. I'm just making sure I get right in there. I'm not particularly bothered about getting the sides. Okay, so a little more paint. Yeah, I'm not particularly bothered about realism. I think sometimes realism is overrated. We spend too much time in the real world. So let's create something that's more idealized, stylized, more to our liking than what we sometimes get in reality. All right. So those bits of wood there, I need to leave those to dry because obviously I can't heat set them. No, it's not come back on again yet. So either I'll leave that for a while to dry au naturel, or I go fishing for my spare. All right, I got that dried. I had to fish out my old pink machine. while I was looking in the drawer, I actually found another one as well. So I've actually got two spares, which is rather fun. Right, so I've decided what I'm going to do for the colour palette. So we are going to stick with brown for the base coat. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick out all the highlights in other metallic paints. So we're going to have silvers, gold and coppers on top of the brown. So what I need to do is I need to go away and paint all the rest of this stuff in that brown paint. So I've got my brush, got the paint. So this is going to be a bit tedious to watch. Actually, maybe a smaller brush. Maybe a smaller brush. Let's have a look. What have we got there? That'll do. Because it's a smaller area. So I'm going to go around and paint everything with the brown paint, and then I will join with you again Once I've done all that and got it dried, and then we'll be ready to start sticking things on, gluing things together. All right, so everything is pretty much dry now. I've just been checking on my glue, my 3-in-1 Beacon Advanced Craft Glue. It says solidified in the bottle. Elmer's School Glue, empty, run out. So I'm going to have to rely on the Indigo Blue Grab and Go, which I only bought last week. Well, I say bought. Stole from the shop. I did tell them I was stealing it though, so that's all right. Right. So that, stole with permission, by the way. In case you were wondering. Right, so on the back of that, because I use a lot of the products and design a lot of the products, they do tend to just say, just take one. Just have it, which is nice of them. Okay, so we're about up there, I think we said, for the barbed wire, and then let's just put a little bit down there on the body. Not sure where this is going to touch. So I want that towards the bottom bit, about there. I know it's all kind of disappearing into one, and it is kind of flat, but once you actually get your yeah, colour on there. I say colour, I mean you kind of, you metallics, it will liven up and it will dry completely clear, the glue. So that's all right then. Try and make sure I've got everything as straight as I possibly can, and then we'll go in with the glue. To come down a bit. I love these little kits. Not trying to blow my own trumpet or anything, but just having something that you can pull off the shelf and just play with. Oh, like I said before, if you're having a play date with a friend, I know some people have like craft dates with their friends, and whoever's hosting for that particular craft date, if you like, sorts out the project. So this would be a nice thing for you to do. If it was your turn to sort out something different. Oops, caught the end on that. And unexpected. Particularly if you're not, you know, you're not in the mood for card making or scrapbooking or even doing an art journal page. Something like this. You know, set yourself a little competition of, you know, working outside the box or working with colours that you don't normally work with or that kind of stuff. Different materials, different colours. I mean, you could do two or three different ones, all with different colours, all with different bits and bobs, different layouts, different orientations. Okay, so that's the basic composition glued down. So what I need to do now is leave that to dry before I come back in and start doing some dry brushing on the actual project itself. So I'll see you in a little while. All right, so that's had enough time to kind of grab and hold now. I've also had a chance to go out and make myself a little cup of coffee. Oh, so I'm happy. Right, and I did a little bit of testing with some copper gilding wax, or luster wax, if you like. So I'm going to carry on with that. So I'm going to use the lid, just pick up some of the wax on the brush. And then all I'm doing is I'm just coming in with that wax and just catching those areas that I want that copper wax to pick up. It's not really dry brushing with this because I'm actually going a little bit heavier and really making sure that I'm covering all the surface rather than just the edges. And I'm not too bothered about the bits underneath. So you can go as heavy as you like with this. And again, we'll go over the barn stars with the copper. Using a small brush to do this so that I can get into the little areas. If I used a bigger brush, I'd catch more surface area. See the shine on that already. So just picking up the top. Lovely, like that. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a mess and make a noise. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to come in with a little bit of alcohol. This is methylated spirits, what we use here in the UK, which is the same as your rubbing alcohol in America. The only difference being ours has got colourant, which if you try and drink it, it'll make you throw up. And it also dissolves wax with it being a solvent. So you can spray some onto a tissue to get your brush, and then if you just rub the brush on the tissue, you can clean any of your wax off and then just dry it. So I'm going to use the same brush, but this time with a different colour. So I'm going to come back in now with the gold. And I'm going to pick up on those horns. You could use gold paint, obviously, if you want to. I haven't used the wax for a while. and I kind of fancied doing it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pick up a little bit of that gold on those stars as well, but not the big band stars, just on those little stars. So this is where I had that texture that we added in for on the horns. So I'll clean that off again. Here we go. Clean as a whistle. Right, silver. Right, so when I was looking in my wax collection, I've actually got three or four different types of what I call silvers. I've got a graphite colour, and there's also brushed iron. I've also got old silver, as well as this silver as well. So there's three different types that I can have a go at. But as soon as I'm using the Sizzix, I'm going to just try and stick with the Sizzix. So all I'm doing is just rubbing gently on the surface. And then just blending gently when it comes to hitting the gold on the horns. And then up and down. And then just on the inside. To kind of give it a little bit of a highlight. I'm just going over with a couple of really light coats. Just keeping the brush kind of angled different ways each time. And then if you wanted to, you could just add a little bit of a highlight onto those kind of copper areas. Just to kind of give it a little bit of a variation in colour tone. Like it. And then I'm going to just clean off the brush once more, because I've got a little bit more colour that I just want to add. Right, and that is old white. So I'm going to put a little bit of that on my worktop here. And with that, I'm going to just try and just keep the brush level. And then just pick up some of that wood grain texture. which just helps to kind of lift it a little bit. I mean, you could grab a really small flat brush if you've got one. He says hunting rapidly. There we go. Might actually be the same size, but I can use it this way. It just helps to lift everything. Gives it that kind of faded, silvery outside look. The sort of look that you get when you leave wood outside, that kind of silvery light grey kind of look. And again, you can build this up as much as you want. So the wax that I'm using is the Art Alchemy Matte Wax in Old White from Prima Finnebert. I don't use it that often because, to be honest, I'm not that enamored with it. But for what we're doing today, I could have probably got a similar effect just by coming in and doing a bit of gesso, considering it's matte, because we've already got waxes on. I just thought that it probably would match better. But I may be wrong. Let's give it that kind of silvery, well, I won't say cedary look, because does cedar go that colour? Quite possibly. Who can say? There we go. That'll do. That will do, I think. Enough. There was enough alcohol left on that from the last time to give it a good clean. And if I wanted to, I could come back in again with a darker colour and just rub those on the edges. I've got sepia here as well, which is sepia, potato. Let's just take a real small amount. Just put it on the finger. I don't suppose it's going to make that much of a difference. Yeah. doesn't really age it that much. Now you can virtually, you can hardly even see it. All that's doing is that's actually just taking a little bit of that silver off. So when you add one colour on top of the other, sometimes the one underneath does get lifted off. So let me come back in with that silver again. This is my large silver brush that I use when I'm doing my kind of like resin canvases. Hair in that now. Get out. I have to get the tweezers in. Gotcha. Get out of it. So it looks like that brush is losing bristles. At an epic rate, that I think actually we'll call that a day. I don't think we'll do anything else to that. No, I think I'm fairly sort of happy with the kind of like basic colour on that one. Love it. So I hope you've enjoyed watching me create that today. If you have, please remember to give the video a thumbs up, share the video with your friends, and if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel already, you can do so by clicking the button at the end of the video. So this is the Cowboy Ranch Rainy Day Kit, which is on the website now. So if you want it, you know where to go. There's a clickable link in the description area below the video. That's all from me for now. I'll see you all again very, very soon. Bye for now. I'd like to say a huge thank you to all of my angels, because without you, these videos would not be possible. And don't forget, you can access your exclusive angel-only content over on my website. There's a link in the description area below. Thank you.